So it's been a great. The O'Connells have pushed the votes in the east, the O'Donnells in the west. Now I'd like to introduce Jimmy to the table. He's just been released after 6 months in the maze itself, and he's been working in England for us ever since.
Thank you, Jerry. There's no need for any introductions.
I know who you are.
Excuse me?
You're the one who handled a close friend of ours, Connor. I'd say pretty poorly.
Connor
McGovern. He used to sit in the chair you're sitting in now. Always pushing out the same bullshit that I don't care to listen to. The difference is he's loyal and familiar. When he was inside, he beat him. He beat him like a dog.
Patrick, I think you got the wrong idea.
Quiet. Like a dog for himself. What have you got to say for yourself?
Sorry.
Yeah, you find it funny? Well, why don't you try doing it again? What have you got to say for yourself?
Sorry for what I did. But he made an attempt on my business. On
his business is my business. And stand when you talk to me. Stand!
Now listen to me, Nate. I need you to get on the bed for Daddy. Hey, come on, we can leave that. Get down there, son. Get down. Don't be scared, son. Look after your brother, Nate. Just look after your brother. And do not compromise under this bed. Do you hear me?
Sculpture, it's interesting.
How do you find it interesting?
Is this how you diagnose your patients? Depending on their answer, you know if they're suicidal or not.
Are you feeling suicidal?
No, not now anyway. So why did you choose that sculpture?
It was a gift.
Gift? From whom?
The patient.
Are you allowed to accept gifts from patients?
Not really, but I thought it was compelling, so I accepted. And there it is.
Here it is.
It is Hercules fighting off evil, which can be seen as anything, fear, depression, anger, and it showcases his strength.
Does that mean I'm evil?
No. No, that's not what I'm saying.
Beautiful.
Stanley, must you always do that?
I'm sorry.
Now, look at this.
Oh, here you go.
Thank you, son.
Come on. Stanley.
Oh, I'm getting old. I can't even stand up without getting out of bed.
You're not old.
Oh, you.
Go on. Play us a tune.
Oh, I couldn't now. I'm too winded. Tell me about your day.
Nothing special. Went for a ski and then did the food shop.
You've been up that foolish mountain again, haven't you? Just like your father.
I do it every morning. It's fine.
Yes, and one of these days you'll take a fall flying down there like a lunatic. Off-piste is so dangerous. Why can't you ski in the resort like everyone else? You might meet someone. Away from England all these years and you still have no friends here.
I have no friends because this is the life I've chosen.
It's all right, Stanley, it's fine.
Is it?
What's on your mind, son?
Nothing.
Tell me what's troubling you, Stanley. I don't want you getting all upset again.
I just feel... No. Forget it. I'll go and prepare the dinner. What would you rather do? Talk things through like men? Or be a child and put innocent people in harm's way? Have we not all lost enough? We all know what it feels like to lose someone we care about or someone we love. It's how we handle that and keep going. Not for ourselves and at least for our families. My friends, the era of the gun is over.
Give us another drink, will ya? Dave?
Yeah?
Logan, no, no.
What? Can I say hello to a friend?
How do you, friend?
What I do to fuck you?
Fuck off, Logan.
Hey, what you doing here?
Here to see Reuben.
Reuben? What you walking for?
Not for you to know.
No? Why is that? Am I not worthy of such information?
Ethan, would you just leave it be, please?
Why? Now we told each other everything. Yes. It's not right. Am I not making sense to you? Any of you?
Reuben, we need to talk.
Now calm down, Dave. We'll talk in a bit.
I think we should talk now.
Can you give us a moment, lads? What couldn't wait?
How long have you known?
Known about what?
Don't be stupid with me.
Follow me.
Steady on. What makes it right for you to storm over to me in my bar? At my table, like a little girl having a tantrum and throwing her toys out the pram. We were talking serious business in there. Did you know that?
We're talking about setting up an old man's club. It's hardly serious.
Oh, fuck's sake, me.
Why didn't you tell me?
But I told you. Rosaline again. She never knows when to keep her blind mouth shut.
Tell me why.
I'm sorry, all right?
Fine, just... tell me what I came here to find out and get out of your way.
You tell me why, and I might give it to you.
Because I want to know. That's why I ask.
But you see, that's where you're going wrong. It isn't what you want in life that's important. It's what you need. Wait here. Is this what you need?
How long have we had this?
For a while now. Now listen, I had this information because I wanted to do something about it myself. Way back when you were too young to understand. And the only reason I didn't follow through on it was because of my family. That's a lot to lose.
So you made a difference. You still have your family all in my back?
I like to think of you as my family.
You know what I mean?
I know. When I took you in, I held you in my arms and I saw that your heart was broken. As time passed, I got to see it bend. I don't want you to turn him back into that wee sad girl again, especially after all this progress. I hope you get what you're looking for.
Eve, can you wait? Eve, can you just wait up for a second? Are you right?
Yeah, everything's fine, why?
Why? You just looked really aggravated earlier before you wanted to speak to Reuben. What do you want to talk to him about?
I told you it's none of your business.
But it is, though.
What?
It is. My business, especially if you started hurting yourself again. I'm the first person you need to be talking to about that sort of thing.
What possibly makes you think that that's your business?
Because I'm your boyfriend.
Look, Ethan, we go over this all the time. I see you like my brother.
Look, I got you something.
What?
I was in Italian. Walked around the market, and I got on that. And thought of you. You like it?
It's lovely, but I can't accept it.
If you don't have it, then I'm not going to give it to anybody else, then am I?
Thanks.
You're welcome. Look, you just seem really stressed, and I really think it would do you the world of good to talk to somebody about what's going on, especially because I've told you all about my own foster parents in the first place, so...
I just don't want to talk about this.
That's not how this works.
I've got to go.
Can you just finish the complaint, please? And we can talk about it. Why don't you just tell me what the... Fine. I was hiding from the truth. Coward. That's just rubbish.
What is?
That if we make a wrong decision, we shouldn't beat ourselves up about it, that we should just forget it happened. But what if the decisions that we make cause pain and distress to someone else?
Have you hurt someone by a decision you've made?
Again, you answer a question by asking a question. Is this therapy or is this an interrogation?
I'm sorry you feel
that way. Wouldn't you just help me so that I can buy you a pointless gift and live happily ever fucking after? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to swear.
It's fine. How was your week?
Okay. That's a lie. It was crap.
Have you been writing in your journal?
No.
Why not?
I felt stupid.
It's confidential what you write in there. No one will see it, not even myself.
Then what's the point in it?
It's just a way of expressing yourself, releasing some tension on your mind.
I wouldn't know where to start.
Just write. It will come naturally. Expressing yourself is good for your health. Containing it will destroy you. It's when you were in the army that's getting to you, isn't it? Stanley? Come sit back down.
I'm sorry, Bernadette. I know you're trying, but like all the previous therapists, you can't help me. I'm tired. I'm gonna get an early night.
Oh, okay. Are you sure you're all right?
I'm fine. Good night.
Good night, darling.
Something.
Sit down, boy.
Thanks.
What's on your mind?
Niamh. She's gone. Don't know where. This is driving me mad.
Let's just say she's somewhere now and she'll be back in a few weeks and nothing to worry about.
So, you know where she is?
She's fine, boy. Don't be worrying yourself.
But
they tell me where she is? It's not for me to say where she is. Just go home and relax.
Okay. Why won't you tell me where she is?
Now, you're getting on my last nerve with all these questions. Will you let it be?
This is crap. She's my girlfriend. I have the right to know where she is.
You naive. Will you let it go? Listen, let me give you some friendly advice. Women are strange creatures. It's like it's in their DNA or something. Times they make you feel good. Sometimes real good. And times they make you feel bad. See, let's get real. You're in the friend zone. A place where a woman will keep you for as long as she likes. If I was you, keep some dignity and let it go.
Right, that's it. You're done now. Spare me the father routine room and you don't know me.
Hold on.
Now, you hold on for a minute. I'm sick and tired of old fuckers like you telling me what I can and cannot do. You just have no respect, and I've done more than enough to earn your respect.
Don't you reach
out! Shut up! What the fuck? Shut the fuck up!
You don't know what you've done.
I know exactly what I'm doing. You're opening on the plane, all right? Tell me where she is, or I'll slice your fucking throat. You ain't gonna do shit.
Just tell him.
Tell me where she is, Ruben. No? You don't want to tell me? Fine. Fair enough. You know what? Maybe you're right. Maybe I'm not going to stand you, but Logan... Oh, I think Logan's going to kill your barmaid. You are a dead man.
Yeah,
and you need to be really clever like all your other little fuckers think you are. And you need to tell me where she is.
Can I get on the slope today?
No.
Can I buy you a drink?
I already have a drink.
Yeah, top up maybe.
No.
No, I haven't figured you out yet. I will.
What are you talking about, Nolan?
Well, there isn't much else to do here apart from ski and drink.
I am drinking. I just don't want to drink with you.
Yeah, well, no harm in making friends.
I'm looking for someone.
Who?
I don't think you know him. He's not exactly the ski instructor type, I'd imagine.
Well, being the ski instructor type, I'm a taxi service for tourists. I get to meet a lot of people. I don't give a name to this.
Or I don't know.
Well, if you tell me his name, I might be able to help. I'm a known man around this place. Look, let me get you a top up, and I might be able to help.
Hi.
Oh. Yep, I know everyone around this place. The one with the information, I'm the go-to guy. Be able to use his please. So, what part of Northern Ireland would you say you're from then?
I didn't. Belfast.
To Belfast! And? Friendship. Same again. So. Who is it you're looking for?
Like I said, you probably won't know him.
Well, how about this? If you name who it is you're looking for, and I don't know him, scouts on up, I'll buy the drinks all night.
Fine. I'll take your offer. His name's Stanley Winters.
Who?
Stanley Winters. Yeah, didn't think you'd know him.
Hang on. No.
Fine, I must have been misinformed.
I know it's Stanley Winters. Question is, why do you want him?
Are you just aware of it? Where would I find him?
Don't know where he lives, but he skis down Shimandoah most days. No one skis down Shimandoah. It's avalanche country.
Thank you.
lovely place here. A bit away from civilization, it's nice.
Yeah.
You seem a bit startled. Are you in a rush?
Yeah. Got some of the meat.
No, wait. Wait. I look okay. Oh, my leg.
Relax a moment.
Oh, my camera's broken.
Can you walk?
I think so. Ah.
Oh. Shouldn't be up here alone. This mountain's dangerous.
It's not my fault. If you hadn't ignored me in the first place and skied off, I'd never have fallen.
Yeah, well, I'll help you up. I'm going to carry you.
I didn't know you're not.
You got any better ideas? My house is at the foot of the mountain.
Me to take my boots off?
No, that's fine.
So you're in the army?
That was a long time ago.
How long exactly? Stanley, is that you?
Yes, Mother.
I thought I heard you talking to someone. Were you talking to yourself again?
That'd be me.
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry, you gave me a fright there. I didn't mean to intrude. I didn't realize you had company, Stanley.
She had a fall on the slope. She'll be on the way soon.
A fall? Are you hurt?
Just my leg.
Well, is it bad?
It's a bit swollen.
You must get her something for the swelling.
She has something.
Oh, that's good. Goodness, what were you doing out this far? It's quite dangerous up that mountain.
I know. I was up there taking photos. It's so peaceful out there.
Well, it is lovely, I remember. I wasn't always blind. I used to ski myself. And
how's your knee feeling? Would you like me to call you a taxi?
A taxi? But you've only just arrived. Surely you'll have a tea or a coffee or...
I'm sure the idea of talking over a coffee sounds appealing, but I'm sure you have other things you need to do, right?
Nonsense, Stanley. You must stay and have something to eat. I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
It's Neve.
I'm Mary. Are you hungry?
I am a little.
Rather. Then how about dinner? We don't have guests very often. I would love you to stay for dinner. Will you stay?
If it's not too much trouble.
Not at all. That's that then. Would you be a treat and help me pick a dress for dinner?
Sorry?
We must dress for dinner. Like I said, we don't have visitors very often. This is a special occasion.
This is a gorgeous color.
Bring it to me. The red silk. The red silk dress.
How do you know?
I couldn't forget this dress if I tried. 1985, the last time I wore it, we danced. My husband and I, our wedding anniversary. But it wouldn't fit me now. Why don't you try it?
I couldn't.
But it would look wonderful on you.
It's beautiful, but what would I wear on my feet?
Shoes. Have a look in the bottom of the wardrobe. There are some shoe boxes in there. There should be a little black pair somewhere.
Cool camera. My dad had one years ago.
Oh, that old thing. I hasn't seen the light in years.
Polaroid? Does it still work?
I don't know. I should think so. You're into photography. Why don't you have it? It's no use to me collecting dust here.
Thank you.
It's nice to have another woman to talk to.
It's very kind of you to let me stay.
It's me who should thank you. Having you here is good for Stanley, too.
Stanley?
You look beautiful, Mother.
Please stop and do it in company all the time.
have you lived here?
Almost 5 years now, since the accident. How quickly time goes by.
I mean, it is beautiful, but there's not a lot to do here.
It's where we came when Stanley was a boy. It was our second home. His father loved to ski. It just seemed the right place to come back to.
It's all so quiet. There's not many people around.
Stanley isn't one for crowds, as you can tell.
Yeah, but it's very isolated. Doesn't it worry you being up here all alone? Like, what if something happens?
She's not alone. We look after ourselves.
I didn't mean it like that.
Neve was telling me she's from Belfast. You were stationed there, weren't you, Stanley? I've heard it's a beautiful place.
Yeah, it is.
And do you have a big family, Neve?
To be honest, I haven't got much family left.
Oh, that's a shame.
What is the reason you're here?
I'm having a bit of a break from my boyfriend.
Oh.
We needed some time apart, and the app seemed as good a place as any to clear my head.
Well, relationships can be very tricky to get right sometimes. You can often feel like running away.
Oh, I'm not running. I just needed some time.
Looks like you're running.
Stanley.
I know, he has a fair point. I just needed some time alone.
That camera we found in the water.
Yeah, of course I will, Mary.
Make an old lady very happy.
Do you really have to do this?
Stanley. She's a young woman on her own in a strange country, and she's obviously been through a lot.
Yeah, well, we all have.
Why are you being so hostile towards
her? I'm just not ready to make friends yet. My mind's all over the place.
Could you at least try? This is a happy night. Not everything has to make sense.
Got it?
Oh, wonderful. Let me show you. Where are you now, Stanley?
Here.
Ah, there you are.
You ready?
Hang on, you've got to be in this too.
Well, I can't set it to take an automatic photo, it's too old.
No, you just hold it out and turn it towards us.
Okay. Right. All smile.
Could I have it, please?
It'll take a minute.
This is where we'll put it. How is it?
It's perfect.
Yes. Will you leave, son? I only wish your father was here to share it.
So do I.
I know how hard it's been for you looking after me when you have your own life to worry about. But I want you to know there's never been a moment when I had to push it. And out of everything, if I could choose to see anything again, just once, I would see your face.
Oh,
no,
I'm not sure.
I wasn't asking.
No, Mother, this isn't a good idea.
Stanley!
Mother, no. I'm not dancing anymore.
I'll do the washing up.
Mother.
If you want to be discourteous to our guest, then so be it.
Let me...
No! You always do it. It's only for her that I did it this time.
No, don't. Please, leave it. I'm sorry about that.
No, it's fine. What is it?
Your wrists.
I don't quite see what it is you're getting at.
If you need to talk to anyone, then... Look, we all have our demons. It's just how we deal with them.
You want to be the hero, is that it? You want to save the damsel in distress? In my wrists, I like this, because I tried to take my own life. On more than one occasion, actually. Sometimes the thought of death, even just the word, is comforting to me, but I keep going because my heart wants something.
Okay, calm down. What is it that you want?
It's not what I want. It's what I need.
Mom? Mom, what's happened?
Mom, are you all right?
I'm tired.
Let me take you out to bed. It's been a long day.
No, I mean I'm tired of being old.
Mum, you're bleeding. Let me see it.
I can do this. I don't need your help.
Mum, look. Leave all this. I'll finish that.
No. I need to do it. And you need to find someone to share your life with. This is no life for you here with me.
This is where I want to be.
I'll show you the directions to the town in the morning. No, it really was nice meeting you. Say something earlier. What was it?
It was nothing.
Really?
Yeah, honestly, it was nothing.
Good night.
Therapy. Why do you ask?
This is a sofa. There's room for two.
Yes, I do.
Marital problems? Work? Stress? Sex life?
Oh, many things.
Anything interesting?
I can't disclose such information.
Fair enough. I wrote in the journal.
Good. How did you find it?
Interesting. It made me realise that I really am damaged goods.
That is an interesting observation.
No, really. I better be going.
We will continue this tomorrow morning if you're free. I know we normally meet once a week, but I think it would be good to carry on with this fresh in our minds. Okay.
See you.
See you tomorrow.
Like we should have done back in Belfast after all the times I buried my soul. That's what couples do, by the way, near.
We're not, Ethan. And the sooner you get that through your thick skull, the better we'll both be.
And that's it. You're just gonna fucking say that. I come here and you say that. Alright. You're gonna make a decision right now. Is it him or me? But if you come back to me, Nia, if you come back to whenever you want, I'll forgive you for all of this shit. But if you go to him, I'll never speak to you again. Touch me, just tell me what you want. I
can't breathe.
That's it, that's your last word. Alright, I want it back, I want the bracelet back tonight. I want the bracelet back tonight.
That's enough. You're letting that bitch walk all over you.
Just leave her, leave her.
But that's not what we agreed.
I don't care what we said, leave her here, let her rot here. I never want to see you again. Do you hear me?
I said, do you hear me?
I do.
Hey, Stan, how you doing?
Not bad, thanks. Yourself?
Yeah, not too bad. Something.
Did my order come in?
Yeah. I got it here.
It cost me a fortune to buy such a package. Anyway, thanks, Jim.
Hey, before you go, did she find you? Your niece, is it?
Your niece?
Yeah. A pretty young thing. Dark hair. She was asking after you 3 days ago.
Yeah, you must have me mistaken for someone else.
Maybe not. Maybe it was me. My mistake.
Wait.
See ya.
It's bloody cold, eh? And what is wrong with you, boy? You come out all this way just to tell her off? Not even a slap on the wrist? You should be ashamed of yourself. Are we really going home?
I don't mean to do, Logan.
What do you think? You should kill the bitch.
Come on.
Seriously? She has disrespected you and she's disrespected our culture by going with a man like that. A fucking Englishman.
You don't know he's English.
I do. I can smell it. You turn that engine off, for Christ's sake. This is what we're going to do. We're going to split up. One take out the Englishman and the other go up to our house and bring that bitch back.
Right, and what if she doesn't want to come home? You're out of your mind.
You drag me out here to bloody France so I can do what you don't want to. You call yourself a man? You let a fucking woman tread all over you like you're nothing.
No, that's why I don't understand. When I first met her, she'd be really nice to me. Listen, you know, like, properly listen. And so I told her about my father dying and only one. And she put her arm around me and said, Ethan, I understand. And from that moment, I knew we were meant to be. Well, I thought we were meant to be together.
It's a damn shame. But she has got to go. We've come this far. So we might as well finish it. If you're not going to, then I am.
All right, just wait. All right, then. You had these in the boat the whole time?
Aye.
Huh? That border control, could have got caught.
They don't check unless you're black or a Muslim.
That's a load of crap, and you know it.
What? You'd rather we stuck them up our arseholes then?
No, I wouldn't know you'd love that under.
Your ma loves it, doesn't it? Right, you got the house or the hill?
Nice. This was the house. I'll take the house then.
You sure about that?
Yeah, I'm sure. Thank you.
far.
Gave you this? How do you know where I live?
You think I'm gonna tell you that? Then you're as dumb as I expected.
As you expected? You don't even know me, boy. Now tell me, why are you trying to kill me?
Why not? I do things like this because sometimes it gives me pleasure to fuck with people's eyes. Only real reason I'm out here in this shit box of ice.
The right answer.
I'm the least of your worries. Well, you're here. My friend is probably having fun with your mother, not dick.
Something that nobody else in the whole world. And
we loved each other. That's why it's such a fucking shame, you.
But you've been a very, very disloyal girlfriend.
Sorry.
What have you done?
leave you alone.
Sit down. Thank you. I can't even remember the last time I told her I loved her.
She knew.
Did she? One thing that gets me. She died in the darkness. Alone. But I should have taken that bullet, not her. Tell you what I've deserved for the things I've done.
What did you do?
Who are you?
What do you mean?
Don't you fool me around.
You know who I am.
Do I? All this that's happened, you haven't called the police or tried to run, which means that you're either strong-willed or you're unsurprised. And if you're unsurprised, then you knew this might happen. Therefore, you were either working with them or they came here to get you.
I don't think of this.
Jim from the bar said that you were looking for me.
No, I wasn't.
Why? Don't lie to me. Tell me the truth.
I don't know.
Tell me. Have you found who you're looking for? Is it me? How long have you been looking?
Sammy, you're hurting me. I don't know what you're talking
about.
Oh,
you know. You've known all along. You sat at my mother's table and you lied to our faces. And she took you in. She took you in. And in return, I had to place her cold, dead body in the earth. Why?
You killed my brother.
What?
I didn't mean for this to happen. They were coming for me because I was coming for you. You may blame me for your brother's death. And you took everything from me. How many innocent little boys have you killed? All my life I've thought about this moment. What I do to you.
Please, shoot me. Please.
As a child, my brother, he was innocent.
Yes, please, shoot me. Do it. Do it.
My father made a decision for my brother.
Please, shoot me.
Forgot, but we had a session booked for this morning and it's not like you to not show up. I'm concerned for your well-being, so please contact me as soon as you get this. Thank you.
It's just the nature.
future of life.